Hello, and welcome to this episode of Simply Saturday, where I get to show you a card that is fast and easy to make. Hi, my name is Julie, and this is Stamp with Julie Baum. I'm super excited to show you this card today. It's a simple card, but it's so amazingly cute. We are using the Trees for Sale stamp set. And let me mention that today's card is completely ink to paper. We are not using any dyes. We are not using any designer series paper, just your ink, stamps, and paper. Now, at our last recent celebration season, there were some dies that coordinate with this stamp set. I believe they were called Tree Lot. Those are no longer available. I'm going to give you a peek at those because they were so overwhelmingly popular that many of you may have already gotten these when they were available. And they included not only the dies for cutting out the stamps, the trees, the dog, etc., but also the adorable camping trailer dies. So those are no longer available. Hopefully you got them when you could, but we are going to just use the stamp set today, and I think you're going to be excited about the possibilities. So we are going to start with a white card base that measures 8.5 by 5.5. I have scored it at 4.25 and folded it down the center. We'll be opening our card this way for our card today. Then I have a panel. This is going to go on the front. This is green. This is granny apple green. Sorry. And it measures 5.25 inches by 4 inches. So this will be going on the front of our card, like so. I have another piece of granny apple green. This piece measures 5 inches by 3.75 inches. This is going to be a panel on the inside of the card. And then I have two pieces of basic white, one for the front and one for the inside, and those measure 4.75 by 3.5 inches. So those are all of your parts. You'll also need a tiny little basic white scrap for stamping and a little fussy cutting. All right, so I was inspired to make this card by another YouTube video that I watched, but I have simplified it from her version to make it fit into what I like to do for a Simply Saturday. But at the end of this demonstration, I will show you some other cards that were made that are a little bit more embellished, and so they would not be able to qualify for a Simply Saturday. In the background, you may be hearing my new little dog. We adopted two dogs yesterday. Come here. And they are still getting a little bit used to their new home. Their names are Cabby and Pino, and both of them are tiny little Yorkshire Terriers. So you might be hearing Cabby yipping in the background because she wants my attention right now. All right, the first thing I'm gonna do is attach our front panel to the front of the card so that we can set that aside. I'm just using my liquid glue to do this. This would be one of the steps that you could embellish or step up, so to speak, if you wanted. You could do an embossing folder on this piece if you chose to. All right, so there's our front panel. We're going to have a panel on the inside as well. We can go ahead and put that in place. Okay, so I'm just centering it on the inside. A stamped white piece is going to go on top of this as soon as we've created it. And we're going to do that at this point. We're going to do the inside panel first, then we'll come back and do the majority of the stamping, which goes on the front. All right, so for the inside panel, I have chosen to use the stamp that says Christmas Greetings. And I'll be stamping with shaded spruce. I forgot that I took this off when I was moving my stamps and my blocks around, so let me grab it from the case. Here we go. All right. Christmas greetings and shaded spruce. So this greeting is going to go at the top center of this piece and down a little ways from the top, like so. It's a beautiful green. Then I'm going to take the trees. Now there are three sets of trees in this set, a large, a medium, and a small. So I'm going to take the medium, and what I've done is I've just mounted the stamps on one block. I have the main tree shape here. So with my granny apple green, I'm going to pick up ink. I'm going to stamp that onto my scrap paper first and then onto the card. This gives me a lighter version of that granny apple green. And then flip my block over, and I've got the detail part of that same size tree. So I can add the branches in granny apple green straight from the ink pad right onto my card. Then I'm going to take the little stand for the Christmas tree, and I'm using crumb cake for this. And I am going to stamp it off. On the front of the card, we'll use some that's full strength and some that has been stamped off. So there's the base. And then I think it's fun to add the little Christmas bulbs or lights. So we're using this stamp. And only through a little bit of trial and error have I learned that I like to ink up the top three. There's kind of a triangle of little spots. I like to ink that up by itself first and stamp at the very top of this size tree, like so. Now I'm going to ink the whole stamp and just reposition and stamp that. And it kind of gives me good coverage on those red bulbs. All right. Let's go ahead and attach that to the inside panel. And I'm just going to lay it down with that liquid glue. I'm able to slide it a little bit to get it evened out. Like so. Now this is interesting. As I'm placing this, I feel like my measurements were not what I originally started with, because I would like a little bit bigger border on the side of this. So we're going to go with it, because often that's what we do when we're stamping. But if you want to make a note, I think that actually my original, the inside panel would have been 5 1/4, not 5 inches. So if you want this green to just show a little bit more, you can make that piece just a little bit larger. So I don't know what happened there when I transferred all my notes over, but it did end up a little bit skimpy. All right, so now I'm going to go back to my other piece of white, and we're going to stamp for the front of the card. The first thing I'm going to do is put the string of lights on. This also I learned by trial and error. The first couple cards that I made of this design, I did the trees first and then kind of fit the lights in. And then I switched my method and I liked it so much better. So that's how I'm going to teach you how to do it. All right, so I've got Memento black ink. I have the string of Christmas lights, and I'm going to stamp it very near the top and the center of this white piece. All right, in doing that, it gives me an indication of kind of the margins that I want to keep my tree lot within. Now, it doesn't have to be exactly within this edge to this edge, but it's going to be a really good indicator. So with that said, let's put our trees on. I'm going to use the largest tree first, and I'm using shaded spruce. I've got the basic tree shape that I'm going to stamp off. And then stamp, and I'm going to go kind of towards that left edge of the area that I've given myself. And then also with shaded spruce, but straight from the ink pad, and this time with the detail of the tree branches. We're gonna do a second tree in shaded spruce, stamping off. And then this one I'm gonna put over here. You can certainly play with the position of your trees. I did, each one came out a little different until I kind of found the one that I felt like worked the best. All right, so there's the first two trees. Now we're gonna change colors and size. So I'll go to the medium tree and granny apple green. First I'll do the main shape of the tree, and this one I'm gonna do quite a bit lower and in the foreground of my tree lot. Flip it over to put the detail on with granny apple green. Oh, these trees are just so fun to build. They're super easy and really effective. Now here's kind of the surprise. I'm gonna use Coastal Cabana, which we usually think of as a blue, or at least a blue-green, but it works really nicely with our trees. So in this one, I'm going to place one kind of up here in the back, and it doesn't matter if they overlap a little, it's gonna be fine. And I'm gonna do a second one right here in the foreground. Let's go with that. Okay, so I did the basic shape twice just because I was in motion. Now I'll add the detail of the branches with Coastal Cabana straight from the ink pad, like so. Okay, now we're gonna attach our little base to each tree. So just to mix it up a little, I'll use Crumb Cake straight from the ink pad, so full strength on my darker green trees. I'll stamp off for this little one and my granny apple one. And then this one's a little tricky because it's tucked back in there. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of stamp the left edge of it. See, I just kind of fudged a little. You can't really tell that it's right there. You just need to stick it in if that's how your trees ended up. Okay, now we're gonna take this pole stamp so that we can attach our lights to something so they're not just hanging there in the air. Also with Crumb Cake, and I'm going to use the little rounded end as the top, and I am going to try to attach it right here to the black line of my lights. Now, this will probably be the case on your card as well, that you're gonna go right over your tree. It totally doesn't matter. It just looks like the tree is behind it. So don't worry at all. But again, by stamping that little string of lights first, it did give me a really good indication to try to have most of the trees in between and then just spilling out a teeny bit. Doesn't that look great? Okay, I'm gonna take that scrap of white that I mentioned and stamp the little sign that says trees for sale, and I'll do that in Crumb Cake. I have also done it in Soft Suede, which also looks really good. It's just a darker brown. So it's totally up to you. For Simply Saturday, I wanted to use fewer changes of ink pad, so I stuck with Crumb Cake. Now, if you happened to have been lucky enough to get the dies, there is a die that will cut that out. In the event that you did not get the dies, it's just a couple of quick cuts with our paper snips, and anybody can make these couple of straight cuts. So let's fussy cut this out. All right, here I'm gonna make a nice tight angle cut around the base. Like so. All right, super easy. Okay, I'm gonna put that in place with a Stampin' Dimensional. And you can determine the placement of your little sign based on kind of how your trees ended up. If you arranged your trees a little differently, then you might want to place your sign someplace different. But you can see that this is going to go really cute just about anywhere. All right, so on this one, because this area is a little bit more blank, I will put my sign there. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and attach this to the front of my card. I was just turning around to check on the girls, and they have given up trying to talk to me while I'm busy stamping. So they're lying down waiting patiently. Okay, so I'm bringing in our card and attaching this to the front. I like that nice big green border. Like so, and now we have one decision to make, and that is how we're going to fill in our little Christmas lights. So there's a number of things that you could do. You could use the little paints that are in the holiday mini catalog and drop those little droplets on. You would need to let them dry. You could use rhinestones, that would be nice. You could simply color them in with markers, which I have done. And on this card, I want to show you what it looks like using the festive pearls. All right, these are currently available and these are going to look really nice. So let's see, we've got six lights. I want two of them to be red. So let's start with red. And I'm just going to set those right in and they become the lights or the little bulbs. All right, let's go red. And then the silver. This one, I think it's supposed to be kind of green, but it's like a pale blue green. I don't really know what color I would call that, but it doesn't matter. And let's add a gold. Our second red. And then we can kind of choose if we either want to keep the pattern up or just whichever is your next favorite one to go there. I think I will. I'll just stick with the silver. Continue my pattern. And there we have it. There is our cute little tree lot with a cute stamp. See, once you bring your tree home, then you decorate it. These are plain because they're at the tree lot. Now, let me show you a couple of the others just so you can see the extra elements that you could add if you weren't trying to make a Simply Saturday version. All right, so on this one, the green piece has been run through an embossing folder, just giving it a little bit of a texture. And then these are the holiday rhinestones, which also look super fun, shiny, and colorful. So you could do that to finish it. This is what it might look like if you just use your markers to fill in your lights, and that's totally acceptable as well. I did red and green lights. And then here is one more version. This one I just used white pearls because often those cafe lights are just white. And so this is what it looks like if you use the white. Also, let me rewind. On this one, I did an even chunkier texture. This is actually, I don't remember what it's called right this second, but it's a pine tree texture. The thing is, once you put your panel on there, it covers up so much of it. So it's up to you if you want the extra texture or not. So that is our Simply Saturday card for today. Wait, let me bring our finished one back in. There you go. And I thank you so much for joining me today. There will be lots of information below the video if you just open up the description box. I do invite you to subscribe to my channel, and I also welcome comments and of course thumbs up or likes if you enjoy the Simply Saturday card today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.